Howdy folks, it's Glenn with the Cactus Atlas, about to explore Cathedral Gorge State Park in the beautiful state of Nevada. Why don't we start this episode off with a little bit of history? This is a water tower. It's a relic of the 1930s, left here by the Civilian Conservation Corps. According to the sign, what they did back then in the 30s is they pumped water in. See that that pipe at the top? They would have piped water in there and used gravity to push the water down through pipes to service the needs of folks that were visiting the area. Oh, look at that. It's a drone. Sounds like there's a swarm of bees behind me, doesn't it? We've seen lots of works of the Civilian Conservation Corps from the 1930s on many of our journeys here on the Cactus Atlas. I sometimes point it out. The one that comes to mind right now is Chiricahua National Monument. They built a lot of trails over there, and it's really, really impressive work, as is this. Well, we didn't come here to explore history today, though, however. We just came to explore a very alien landscape, one that I've wanted to see for many years. It's very remote, though, hard to get to, not near where I live. Probably about 6.5 hours or so from Phoenix, Arizona. It's just never been convenient until now, and I am so excited to show you guys this and to explore it for the first time. This is a new thing for me, too. Okay, so the general plan that I have today is to walk up this trail a little ways. There's a loop that goes all the way around the park. Not gonna do that full loop today because of time, but I'm gonna go to the Miller Point Overlook. I think there's a little canyon over there somewhere I've seen on other videos and pictures that looks really pretty. And then we're gonna hit up all of the different caves here, or slot canyons, that wind through these weird structures. That is probably the thing I look forward to the most. But before we get started, it's a beautiful morning. Let's go check out the overlook. It is such a striking landscape, isn't it? Unlike anything I've ever seen before. I've never seen anything quite like this anywhere on my journeys. We'll talk a little bit about how this stuff forms and what it is in a little bit as we get a little bit deeper into this, but let's just enjoy. I assume our destination is up there. That must be the Miller Overlook. And yeah, there's some stairs here. So I'm getting a little workout this morning. More than I bargained for, but not bad. Alright, I made it to the top of Miller's Point. I would highly recommend this if you visit. It doesn't take too long. We just came from down there, made our way up to this point. There's a parking lot too if you don't want to walk the stairs right behind me over there. But you really get an awesome view of these strange clay formations that dot the landscape here. It's really neat seeing them from up above, get a few really nice photos. Here's a good map that explains a little bit about where I'm at. You are here. We all are right now. Here's our Miller Point. And I think this is the next site that I really want to see, the Cathedral Caves. So I'm no geologist, as I've told you before, and I hope you come here for entertainment and not so much education, but as the signs up there talked about, all this stuff around here, this really isn't rock, it's clay. It's a type of clay, I believe, called bentonite clay. As the map book says here, if you were here 2.5 million years ago, I would have been underwater. I would have needed gills. This would have been the Pliocene era, and this was a freshwater lake, and these are all the leftover sediments that have now been exposed to wind and rain, but we're about to go deep into these mud spires and these corridors to explore what was once an underground lake and all the nooks and crannies underwater. It's gonna be awesome. So really what I'm looking for is something slot canyon-like. The maps also note, for those that are adventurous, you can crawl through really tight corridors and find hidden chambers in here. It's really hard to imagine. I don't even see where to enter, to be honest. I'm right up against the rocks here. So this is gonna be an adventure. All right, I believe I found the entrance to the cathedral slots. Ooh, it's cold in here, actually. Oh my goodness. There's a cold blast of air because the sun, I don't think, has gotten into these crevices here. Wow, and these things are so tall. They weren't kidding. These are some narrow passages and they just wind everywhere. Wow. Oh my goodness. And that's all it is just mud, like clay, hard clay. That's amazing. Might want to reconsider wearing a backpack or camera bag though, because there's some tight squeezes in here. I can really not fit through with all these bags. I'd have to go remove some of this. Yeah, this is another dead end. It's like a maze. I hope I can find my way out of here when I'm done. Wow. Oh my gosh, look. You can actually squeeze through here, I think, if you want to. I don't think I can fit through there though. You could see other people have. I'm sure I can if I get really fancy, but that ain't gonna happen with all this stuff on. Whoa. But look up. Wow. Okay, so the cathedral slots, amazing, but really short. Unless you can squeeze through that really tight area, there's not much to this. I really hope I'm not missing anything spectacular though. I don't know. I guess if it was like a life and death situation, I could probably get through there, but I got a lot to do today and little time. There are two more slot areas here in this park, so we've got two more to explore. Let's go to the next one and see if we can get further in. You can see all sorts of nooks and crannies in this place too, to explore. Just being outside here is amazing. Such an alien looking place. Thank you. place reminds me of, I think it's the planet Krypton, isn't it, from the Superman movies? I'm thinking of the Christopher Reeve age movies from the 80s when I was growing up. There's just a weird geometry to this that is reminiscent for some reason to me for those like crystalline structures that would be in like Superman's base. Now, I'm not a comic book guy or a movie guy, so I apologize if I sound ignorant, but I think you know what I'm talking about. So weird. All right, I explored this area pretty thoroughly, I would say. Let's hit the car and find some of these other caves or slots. They do call them caves on the map, so that's why I'm using that term, by the way. Okay, I'm at the next area called the canyon slots. So we'll see if this one goes deeper in than the last one does. Some more tight squeezes here. This one might be a dead end, I don't know. Okay, that was another short-lived excursion. I came across another obstacle, just wasn't sure, couldn't see around the corner to know. I think there might be some other slots back here anyway, but I had another couple walking through there with their puppy, and there's only room. You have to, like, if someone comes in and you're trying to get out, like, I had to basically back around to have them, you know, let me get out of there. So keep that in mind, you're not going to social distance here. All right, let's check out this one. See if this one opens up more. Oh yeah. Here we go. This looks pretty promising. I keep saying that, but this one's pretty nice and large. I think this may have been where the folks I just ran into came from. Yeah, look, you can really get back up in here. So far, these slots go back further than any of the other ones yet. It's starting to get like a little dark. Whoa, gotta watch your step too. Let's see. Eventually they all dead end, it seems. Got some helpful tips though from the couple I just ran into, saying the moon caves, there's actually a rope you can climb up if you can squeeze through a really tight squeeze at one point, but wow, this keeps going. We're getting pretty far back in here now. Up. Did we find a dead end? It's quite dark in here. Very cave-like. All right, continuing back here in these canyon slots. Wow. You feel really small in here. And it's almost worrisome, like, you know, this isn't the strongest stuff. I don't wanna contribute to erosion, but, you know, believe me, I could just use my thumb and pluck off as much as I want. Luckily, it doesn't seem like people do that here. All right, starting to get really dark. This one goes back further than any so far, though. It's like a hole in here. What is that? Oh, neat. Does it keep going? Nope, but you can see evidence of mud where water collects down here. See that? Wonder if this thing fills up after a heavy rain. Possible. Wow, you can see how far down we really are, though. Isn't that amazing? So these caves or slots were really cool. I liked them better than the other ones, but only because I didn't push through that tight place. Maybe the other ones are better, I don't know. If you guys happen to know, leave me a comment, because I don't want to miss anything cool, but yeah. Listen to this. It almost sounds hollow. Hear that? Weird. Okay, so I feel like I explored this area well, and that just leaves one more. I know I heard there's a large group at the moon caves, according to some folks that I ran into, so been hanging about in here for a while, but let's head on over to the moon caves because they heard some cool things about it, and I don't know. But so far, these slots are the best of the day so far, just because I could go pretty far back in there. And there wasn't really any obstacles or anything, except for the trail that was off to this way. I was heading back to my car, and then I came across this little area back here, and I saw some people up there. So let's go explore and see if I missed something, but more importantly, let's just enjoy this fantastic place. All right, I got some intelligence from the folks I keep running into back here. They said there's like a cave back here that has like a 50-foot drop. They said to be very careful, but you know, I can't pass that up. That sounds awesome. So let's make our way up here. Yeah, just, there really are no trails per se. You just kind of, you can see where other people have gone up here. You can just see the slightest tinge of color where footsteps have been before you. Oh, wow. I think I found the cave. This is a real cave, man. Whoa. I'm just kind of scooching down like this, slowly, and just sliding down the dirt. I just don't want to twist my ankle. It's my first day of a week-long vacation, so I don't want to get hurt off the bat. So being overly cautious, maybe, getting dirty, but oh, we did it. Whew. All right, let's be very careful. Oh my God. Wow, he wasn't kidding. I think he said you can't see the bottom, but this is really loose dirt here. And I did wear my hiking boots, so I don't have the best footing. I'm not gonna attempt that, I don't think. I hear doves above me. That's probably gonna get crapped on, but that's neat. Look up. There's a ceiling in here too. Yeah, that's cool though, that's worth it. Wow. I can't get too much closer to the edge there, because if you start to slip and slide, you ain't stopping. I guarantee you that. All right. Yeah. Otherworldly is a good term for this. I don't like using that anymore though, because I think it's just an overused word now on the YouTubes. But if anything is otherworldly, this has gotta get into that list. Very alien landscape. So I do wanna make a quick disclaimer, maybe for those of you with little kids. I was saying earlier, this would be a great place to let your kids go play hide and seek, explore, but now you saw that big pit of despair back there. So that's my public service message for today. Just be careful if you got little kids and you're gonna let them go explore, because there is stuff like that to be found back here. All right, so out of all of the slot areas, these are the moon slots. I think that has the coolest name. More of the same formations all around. I saw some people walk right back that way. So let's go check out these moon slots. I'm gonna go this way because this looks like maybe another potential area. And the folks that I saw did not go this way. So I'll let them have fun in their spot and I'll go check this out. Oh wow, that's cool. Tight squeeze, my hat keeps getting knocked around in my face. I don't know why I keep bringing my sunglasses, because I keep taking them off. Moon cave so far, kind of tight. Started off really nice and big and open, but we're gonna keep going this time now. Boy, oh boy, this is tough with a stupid camera bag. Oof. Come on, my goodness. All right, what we got here? Yeah. Oh, dead end. Boom. Right in my face. So far, the moon slots are pretty legit. Those go back a pretty good ways, and I found all dead ends. So I'm gonna go try to explore the other spot that I saw folks walking back to. Hopefully I gave them enough time and we don't back ourselves into a corner in there. This looks very well traveled, so this might be the ultimate spot. That's what my hope is anyway. These moon caves are very extensive so far. Lots of different pathways you can take. Spectacular, actually. These might be the best of the bunch, I think. You can see evidence of maybe water collecting down here again. And another dead end, just like all the rest of them, but don't forget to look up. Because I think that's the best part, is just being down in here and seeing all these cool patterns and things on the walls. So one tip I can give you is, like, if you're really afraid of tight spaces, so far the moon slots seem to be the most wide open. So that might be the one you want to try. But I'm really interested in seeing what we can find beyond here. I made it to the other side. Oh my God. Let's see what we got here. Ah, that was dirty. Whew. I'm glad I came back here, because let's see. This thing keeps going and going, see? It's worth it sometimes. Ah, I think I see the rope. Look at that. It's probably not the safest thing for me in my current shape, but that's cool. I used to be really good at climbing rope when I was in elementary school. I don't know how well I'd fare now, but yeah, the people weren't kidding. So if you're adventurous, that's cool. There's like an arch up there. So if you want the ultimate threading a needle, climb the rope, get up there. Looks like there's footholds and stuff too, if you really needed to. I also thought we were done, but there's much more to explore back here too. Maybe we can get up on top of that thing going this way. Wow. Or is it another dead end? Looks like another dead end to me. Maybe, well, maybe not. Never know. Oh, wow. Okay, guys. I was not expecting all this. This keeps going and going. Up. And before you know it, though, another dead end with another beautiful view. Looking up. Ah, look at the filth, the dust. Ah, got dust in my eyes. It's not that bad though. It's all worth it. All right, Cathedral Gorge State Park. That is amazing. I've never done anything quite like that, and sometime I hope you get a chance to check it out too.